Xum chơi những cái chỗ. Ông chú lùm rè, bác cả mặt tò, cái chấm đá ca này tệ vị thi, sạm đá ca. Đâm đá ca, sạm đá ca, nơi rửa xe ní. Đội dạ vầy, đây là khi ông bàn bạp phía kỳ, ông bị bạc mây hơi, ông bị đá ca bị phía, đại trừ sư sạm đá ca nơi rửa xe ní. Cứ ông nhìn rè. Tool nơi cả đặng ai cả xa đã bỏ phía ký để phía ký miền mầm non nông cả đặng nơi ai cả xa cho phù mục ông cho nó nhầm rẻ để mật bàn riêng chồng nông cả đặng ai cả xa nơi nông ngầm lòng phía nơi đầm nào ca phía phía xa đánh đau cả lòng mộc hay miền phành hà để xe xó cứ xong một chừng đặng nơi phía này hay tam bỏ miền thamay thamay khánh tha ai miền bảy hà, rồi viên ca đã ai cả xa tham mây, đam bay tầm ruột đó cái ca này sôm bờ chợ tha, rồi sân bờ miền ai cả xa, rồi viên chả nằm tham mây, cứ sôm nhẹ địa bàn cho bạc lo, cứ bằng hai nằm cả đã ai cả xa đòi bằng hai nhà pí, à tạ thành nhàn này ai cả xa đài sôm lực lang này chụp một ông chưa nhầm ré. Hay bộ tộc mốc cứ xong đòi bánh hà thị phí cứ ai cơ xa thăm mây đài miền bẩm nông xong đã chun chìa phó tan khăn ông rướng đầm bày ở phía kỳ tổ tây tiết miền ca ai bị nứt nơi ai cơ xa thằng nốc môn nâng ông nhầm nè vì bạch thà ta tự tù đã ở cách bị phía xa khăn ông ca bị phía xa đánh đáo nơi chìa phố mốc ông nhầm nè rư gọt nộp. Nà đầm bầy ở bàn đi tệ bị thi bởi bật tế rúa xôn bình chừng khang đầm nàng xã về nhà. Sân bờ miền cả xã xôn nơi đã ai cơ xá xôn bình chừng.
Your Honours, xã về nhà, I stand before you, Lục Rật Thiên, in all humility. In recognition of the fact that today you have completed hearing of evidence in this momentous exercise of finding justice to the Cambodian people in this trial, which has been created on the intersection of national and international laws. This court has been created on the intersection of the desires of the national and international communities to get justice, albeit delayed, albeit at some cost. So I realize the momentous nature of this day when you've finished hearing evidence. And I have this onerous task to bring before you certain further documents that are already on your case file that may or may not be to some extent referred to during the trial that you have heard for these more than 6 months. But just so that a historical record is made of the crimes that occurred as of 21 and of the background and the context in which those crimes occurred at as 21. In the proceedings that are before you, you have led the examination of witnesses quite appropriately so, because you are the trier of fact. You are searching for the truth. And so were the investigating judges when they examined as neutral and impartial investigators evidence that was brought before them either by parties or that they independently gathered. At the same time, the rules that your honors have given us from your plenary casts a burden an onus on the office of the co-prosecutors to prove the case beyond reasonable doubt under 87.1. And what I'm going to do today is not to burden you with further documentation, but a very sincere request on the basis of analysis of all the documents that you have seen or heard in this trial to essentially complement those documents with certain further documents that will make your exercise of judgment a bit more easy. And as we call it in criminal law parlance, you will have the best evidence before you. I have mentioned in my opening few sentences that this court has been created as a marriage of national legal procedure prevalent in Cambodia with that of international standards adopted at tribunals such that are trying crimes of magnitude and complexity as this crime. Therefore, while the national courts of Cambodia in their ordinary municipal jurisdiction would accept the entire case file as the case file for reliance at trial and for their judgment. However, quite appropriately, because of the specific, complex, and a very big nature of these proceedings, where crimes in the nature of hundreds and thousands of individual criminal acts are being prosecuted against an individual for a period of 3 years, 8 months, and few days, it's quite appropriate that complete documentation is before you to assist you at judgment. And this exercise at the end of trial, when we have been able to make a tentative evaluation of what has come before you and what may further assist you in your judgment, is to that effect to give you access to the best evidence such that the making of judgment is facilitated, is made easier for you. After all, we deem this as our duty under 87.1. While creating those internal rules and granting us this burden to discharge, you also said under 87.2 and 3 that certain documents can be brought before you, can be put before the chamber, can be subjected to examination, so that there is a sifting mechanism, a filtering mechanism, and you focus yourselves in your judgment only on key facts at issue. That has also been held by my learned friend and his client in admitting certain facts in the agreed facts that they have provided to your court. It has also been held by some cooperation that this accused has demonstrated. So this background is essentially to tell you that what I am going to embark upon is not an exercise of lock, stock and barrel putting material from the case file before you, but a very sincere and methodical exercise to bring certain more material that complements and may also supplement the material already before you. Now, in respect of these four heads of materials that I'll address, Your Honours, we have had some preliminary discussion with my learned friend, Mr. Rue. He, in his usual magnanimity, has said certain things to us, which I wouldn't want to say, and I'd let him say. So I will essentially bring these documents before Your Honours and let my learned friend respond. Should he have major objections to those documents, I shall revert to them in detail in respect of why they should be taken on record by Your Honour. Now, with that background, let me begin in respect of the four sets of documents that we wish to bring before you, that we wish to put before you so that you use them at trial. The Yawners have, over a period of time, adopted a certain methodology as to how they should be put before you. Yawners, in a trial management meeting on 11th of June, said that it could be treated to be put before Your Honours if it's appropriately identified. And then Your Honours elaborated by saying appropriate identification does not mean reading it aloud in court or even reading its summary, which may be necessary at times, but essentially identifying that document, the name of that document, the ERN number of that document, and certain such other things that very clearly puts it on record. And in my next few minutes of submissions, I shall attempt to do exactly that. Now, as I submitted, all these four heads of documents are before you in some form or the other. One form has been under Rule 92, which once again, Your Honours, rules permit us to bring written submissions throughout the trial till the closing submission to bring to your attention either evidence or arguments that we wish to canvass before you. So we have adopted that mechanism, which in our most respectful submission is quite permitted under the scheme of the rules adopted by you. I shall begin this exercise in the very beginning. The first document, and indeed it's a map that we wish to bring before you, is a map that the learned investigating judges annexed as Annex A to their indictment. This has been clearly on the record before you since the time you received the indictment as confirmed by the pretrial chamber on the 5th of December of 2008. Clearly, there are no three ERN numbers for this. There's only one ERN number for this map. And I can demonstrate to you that map, which has been very helpful for the Office of the Prosecutor in evaluating evidence. It gives a complete pictorial description of S21 and its vicinities. It is at ERN number 002-10940, and this is Annex A to the indictment received from the learned co-investigating judges. The second item that I wish to bring before you, and I will give a one-minute background to that, Your Honours, is a document that we filed on the 29th of April before your court. And this document essentially pertained to the establishment of the existence of an international armed conflict throughout the jurisdiction of this court on the territory of Cambodia between Cambodia and Vietnam. Now, this accused before you has admitted in the agreed facts of the establishment of an armed conflict between Cambodia and Vietnam between 31st of December 1977 till the end of the temporal jurisdiction of this tribunal. While agreeing with that, it is the contention of the co-prosecutors that indeed an international armed conflict existed between Cambodian armed forces controlled by the Khmer Rouge regime and the forces of Vietnam during the entire temporal jurisdiction of this tribunal. My learned friend, in his magnanimity and usual generosity, has not denied that there was not an armed conflict between 1975 and end of 1977. He has left it to Your Honours in the light of evidence before you to determine whether there indeed was an armed conflict between April 1975 and December 1977. Your Honours would recall the expert witness Professor Dayan Chanda mentioned in his testimony that indeed an armed conflict existed throughout the temporal jurisdiction of this tribunal. Therefore, the documents that we wish to bring before you and that we brought before you on the case file on the 29th of April 2009 in the form of the document E61 and its attachments are those documents that we wish to put before you so as to assist you to conclude that there was indeed an armed conflict on the territory of Cambodia for the entire temporal jurisdiction of this court. Now, those documents are contemporaneous documents, some of them created by the DK regime, some of them communiques of neighboring and other governments and the United Nations, some of them magazine and newspaper articles, which, in the absence of a witness before you who has seen all those events, in our most respectful submission, is the best evidence that should assist you to conclude that there was an armed conflict on the territory of Cambodia. Those documents are added as Annex A to our filing E61 of the 29th of April 2009. And just as His Honour the President directed me, I shall give you the ERN numbers first of our filing and then of the Annex A that consists of the documents attached to that filing. Bear with me for these ERN numbers, Your Honours. The English version of this document of 29th April 2009 bears the ERN number, and I shall be very slow, 0032-6308-2-0032-6309. And this document reads, Rule 92 Submission, notification of armed conflict documents to be put before the trial chamber pursuant to Rule 87.2. The Khmer version of this document bears the ERN 0032-6310-2-0032-6312. That's the motion supporting the annexes. And I shall now read the annexes. Annex A bears the ERN 0033-3057-2-0033-3141 in Khmer. In English, it bears the ERN 0032-6313-2-0032-6348. Our discussions with my learned friend on this armed conflict documentation resulted in the observation of my learned friend during the proceedings of this court on 19th May 2009. And I read from those proceedings at page 67 in English. And my learned friend said, I told the office of the co-prosecutors, give me a one-page summary of these press articles. But I was dreaming. My dream would have been that the office of the co-prosecutor, instead of putting all these press articles, would select the most important ones and put them. If I were to understand my learned friend's observation correctly, although he would have preferred those documents, those press articles from various newspapers around the world, some of them in English, some in Khmer, some in French, and some in two or more of those languages, the best option would have been for us to have translated all those press articles into all the three languages of the court. But the other option that he so magnanimously gave us was to give him a summary of those documents. We would most respectfully submit that our submission just now be deemed as a summary of those documents, except if my learned friend still deems that we need to satisfy him further, we would be very happy to do so. This was the second submission, Your Honours. My third submission pertains to the documents that are attached to our filing, a more recent filing of the 19th of August 2009. And this filing, in English, I may read so that it may be translated for the benefit of others present in the court. Co-prosecutors request for the admission of relevant testimonial statements and annotated S21 documents collected during the judicial investigation. This document, following Mr. President's direction, bears document number E-152. Its ERN in English is 00364635 in Khmer, its ERN are 00364650 to 00364672. Now, this filing of the 29th of April, of the 19th of August 2009 has four annexes. Annex A, and once again I must admit that all these documents were obtained, subjected to test and examination by the learned co-investigating judges. First is Annex A, which consists of statements given by this accused before the office of the co-investigating judges. It also includes records, written records of confrontation that the learned investigating judges organized, and the written records of the reconstruction that was mentioned this morning, once again prepared by the learned co-investigating judges. Annex B to this motion consists of witness statements, once again taken by independent, neutral, and impartial investigators of the learned co-investigating judges during the judicial investigation that have been available to the parties since the time they have been available to the co-prosecutors. Annexes C and D of this document of the 19th of August 2009 are about 60 such documents on which this accused, during his chairpersonship of S21, made annotations. A lot of these documents were used by investigators of the investigating judges to put to various witnesses. A lot of these documents were put by the co-investigating judges to this accused.
A
lot of these documents were put in this chamber to this accused and to other witnesses for their comments. In our respectful submission, these documents prove, go to the very core of the issue before you, and which is the role and the extent of participation of this accused for the crimes that are charged against him. They were contemporaneous documents prepared by or under supervision of this accused, which he signed and annotated without fear of criminal prosecution, and in his exercise of full authority as the chairman of S21. Therefore, they shall be of greatest assistance in our most humble submission to your honors in concluding the extent and the nature, and if at all mitigation is called for, of the responsibility and the punishment that should visit this accused. We have also had a discussion about that with my learned friend, and I'll leave it to him to respond to you on what he thinks about these documents. The last set of documents that I wish to bring before your honors, in fact, it's not documents, it is a document, is a book. And this forms the basis of our filing of 24th of August 2009 before your honors. This filing consists of a motion which is numbered 0036992 8 and in Khmer to 0036992 9 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 to 0036 number E160, and it's entitled Court Prosecutor's Notice to Place Nick Dunlop's Book, The Lost Executioner, on the case file and for its admission as trial evidence. We made extensive efforts to find this book in French also. Unfortunately, and actually the author conceded to us that he also felt that that was unfortunate, it is not available in French. It is only available in English and in Khmer. This book, Your Honours, was extensively referred by the learned co-investigating judges. The accused was asked questions about it in the judicial investigation, and so also during the trial before you. In our most respectful submission, this book gives the most complete account of the activities of the accused post Khmer Rouge regime, that is post January 1979. The accused, as he told the learned investigating judges, has read this book, and this book, in our most respectful submission, should be before you, especially when, as my learned friend claims, the whole issue before this court is whether there should be mitigation for the remorse and the apology and the admission of guilt demonstrated by this accused. The ERN numbers of this book, as placed on the case file, are as follows. In English and The entire book is on your record. In English, it is 0036993322 0037027070. In Khmer, it should be 0037027072 0037057539. Now, your honors may tell me, and I ask this question to myself, should books, lock, stock and barrel in an entirety be put before chambers, and should they be burdened upon the judges in their evaluation of evidence? Your honors, we would submit that this would be an exception. This book is written by this journalist who discovered this accused on the life of this accused himself. We requested the learned investigating judges to call Nick Dunlap, the author of this book, as a witness, either as a witness of fact or as an expert. But the learned investigating judges, when we made this request towards the close of judicial investigation, said that the co-prosecutors may make this respect during trial because the investigating judges were in a process of closing and submitting the indictment at an expeditious pace. We also respectfully sought before your honors to call this witness Nick Dunlap. Your honors concluded in your wisdom that it would not be appropriate to call this witness, and therefore, in the light of all this, we would most respectfully submit that since this book has been so extensively referred and cross-referred, it would be in the interest of justice that this is before you. And in making this submission, I would make two observations, and then I shall be done with my submission. The first observation is, Your Honours, that we made requests before learned investigating judges on filing documents that were in the public domain. The learned investigating judges, both of them being very accomplished in their national jurisdictions in the civil law procedures, told the co-prosecutors in their order of the 19th of March 2009, and this concerned a report about the effect of this trial on the lives and mentality of the victims of the Khmer Rouge, said that this is a public document, and if the co-prosecutors or the judicial officers later wish to use any of its findings, they may do so at their wish. Now, we are not citing this as a binding precedent for you, but we would most respectfully submit that this, being a public document available in the public domain, referred extensively during this trial and judicial investigation, read by the accused, subjected to some examination, it should be, and most respectfully ought to be, admitted for your consideration at judgment. Your Honours, these would be my preliminary remarks. And if my learned friend has some very fundamental objections to this, or should your Honours have certain questions to me, I shall be most respectfully available to answer specific questions. But without further ado, I would rest my case here.
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានសូមគោរពលោកប្រធាននិង lúc chạy cầm chiết nâng on đã chiết nâng sum group ông sạ văn ca từng mù nhôm còn tại lướt chia mặt tại láng hơi ca sầm rạch nu vì chỉ chăn tiên được sứt rồi bỏ lúc chạy cầm bỏ lúc chạy cầm sầm rạch giang ná cứ nhôm sum group từ tám nô có phần tại nhôm sum còn tại lướt mặt tại láng nhôm lướt ní lướt chùm bu chùm luốc bắt đáp à vốn rồi viên rót thập hi ba campuchia và chia thập tái nâng rót thập hi ba việt nam chấn chùm luốc bắt đáp à vốn ní việc cất lái rồi viên thân cặp pool rót thập hi ba bắt đi khmai nâng rót thập hi ba rồi bóc việt nam hơi bờ dương bình châu ai cả xa đi từ khnông sầm nông rương lệ sôn mùi đầm bay tùm lẽ cầm hô từ ao tạ đôi vì hạt đôi chia thương nguồn pê mình ai từ tu liệu bàn ní mà giang tiết nhôm thu lọ bàn chun chia mà tệ thả bà sân chia đặt sầm nông rương đi hết là ai cả xa đi từ khnông sầm nông rương lệ sôn sôn pí bà hai chia ai trăm trời chiền ปีพรุ่งจุ่มลวกประดับอาวุธรอเวียงรถทัพพิบาลกัมพูชีหนึ่งรถทัพพิบาลเวียดนามคือเวียการล้างรอเวียงรถทัพพิบาลหนึ่งรถทัพพิบาลเวียมเมนการล้างได้แต่โดยตีเฮ้ยรถทัพพิบาลกัมพูชีคือเวียเมียนบุญเนี้ยเมียนปอลปอลเมียนอิงสรีเมียนวอนเวดหนึ่งซอนเซนสลับออกไปยังในสัลต์yên xử lý mùi chẳng bởi đặt từ khăn ông xâm nông rương lệ xôn xôn bí chăm xua yên xử lý và hai là ai chia lọ chiêng nếu khi nhóm chún chia dụ bó bê nút của thuộc miền chẳng đài hỏi khi nhóm xông bê nút khi nhóm ban phải chạy thêm tiết cả lò màu thả bảo sân nà chia dương dọc rương chùm luộc bắt đắp ở bút rồ viên con tốp rồ bó Campuchia và chia thập bà tay nâng con tốp ở rộng bò xa thiên nạ rốt xong cung dung Việt Nam vô máu cắt tốt tại Khmer cắt tốt tại Khmer hạt đôi chia mình miên dứt tại thô tì Khmer sắp ổ mà cơ quái mà cắt thêm bị lơ tầm lẹ cầm hô lơ nâng tiết khi nhóm dây ní khi nhóm mến canh chương rộng bò Campuchia và chia thập bà tay khi nhóm ớt canh chương thì nhóm sắp ổ là bò còn tay dương giang na cả đói coi dương trâu rốt đồng bây bằng hai dứt tệ thô đó sẽ có lúc và đôi chìa phải chia chuốn căm của chìa đài vì bố thả bờ dốc chùm luộc và đáp ở bốt nữa dù mà đắc cắt nâng nâng từ lơ rốt thập hị ba căm của chìa phải chia thập ở tay cho rốt thập hị ba rốt bó sống cung thì dùng Việt Nam để cắp xâm lắp con tuốt căm của chìa phải chia thập ở tay để chô lên trong tức đây Việt Nam đấy mấy cái kia mình trao thảo cất tạc cam sông kriếm mấy cái mình vô mà cắt tố hội ta tuộc khám ai kì chôn mà tạc đây khám ai chạp chạp vô mà sẽ lạp trao ôi chú khám ai cô rôn cầm mê ní chìa châm nắp ả rôm rô bọc nhôm chẳng thế khi nhôm xùm nôm bó thà cu tạc đắc xùm nôm ở đây là chùm luộc và đáp bảo vốt ní từ khăn nông xùm nông rưỡng lệ xôn xôn phí hạ đôi chỉ tâm trao chiên ai ca xâm rạch giang nà ní khu sạch để chẳng tiên chất bỏ luộc cháy cỏm nhưng còn tầm miên mà tệ đi xôm ọ cùn
Anh chơi nụ mệt vì phòng xóa rú
Oui, Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs, quelques commentaires complémentaires. Après le long exposé du mon collègue du bureau du procureur, je veux bien être magnanime, mais pas stupide. En ce qui concerne le conflit armé dont vient de parler Maître Karsamot, depuis six mois, j'ai dit au bureau du procureur, si vous voulez verser plus de 200 articles de presse qui ne sont qu'en anglais, Mais qu'est-ce que je découvre ?
C'est que,
sous couvert de mon
accord,
il y aurait 5 livres, des rapports analytiques, des rapports militaires, des télégrammes, des
vidéoclips.
Je n'ai jamais donné mon accord à cela. Jamais.
La
carte que vous proposez, nous n'avons pas d'observation. C'était votre premier point. Sur le point 3, témoignage et documents commenté par l'accusé.
Vous
nous reparlez à nouveau d'une annexe A et donc une annexe A à votre nouvelle requête
car
vous n'êtes jamais à court de déposer des requêtes et des requêtes et encore des requêtes. Je vous indique que votre requête du 19 août 2009,
qui fait 15 pages,
n'est toujours pas traduit en français. Je ne sais pas si elle est traduite en Khmer. Ce ne sont pas des conditions de travail convenables. Donc, ce que je comprends dans cette requête du 19 août, c'est que le bureau des coprocureurs souhaite que soit versé au dossier tous les procès-verbaux d'interrogatoire des co-juges d'instruction. Bien entendu, la défense n'a aucune objection à ce que soit versé au débat les procès-verbaux d'interrogatoire des juges d'instruction. Deux fois,
voulant
toujours plus, le bureau du
co-procureur
se permet de viser la pièce 25 qui serait la cote D90 du 25 juin 2008
tiếng lái.
J'attire respectueusement l'attention de la chambre sur le
procès-verbal fait interrogatoire fait partie du dossier numéro 2. Il n'y a pas de figurer dans le dossier numéro 1. Donc,
tous les procès-verbaux d'interrogatoire auprès des juges d'instruction dans le dossier numéro 1, oui, sans exclusion. Tous les documents commentés par l'accusé à la demande des juges d'instruction, qu'ils soient joints à ces procès-verbaux ou qu'ils aient été adressés par la suite par l'accusé. Oui. Bien sûr, c'était le travail des co-juges d'instruction. Et pour gagner du temps, à plusieurs reprises, les co-juges d'instruction ont donné des documents à l'accusé en présence des co-procureurs et ont demandé à l'accusé de faire des commentaires. Tout ça est dans le dossier de l'instruction, bien entendu. Tout cela ayant déjà été débattu de manière contradictoire, la défense est bien évidemment d'accord pour que cela figure.
Vous avez
cependant oublié dans votre liste, messieurs les co-procureurs, qu'il y a bien eu deux procès-verbaux de reconstitution. Je sais que vous en avez très peu parlé de cet acte judiciaire que je continue à qualifier de majeur, mais vous voudrez bien, Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs, être attentif à ce que figure bien dans le dossier, non pas un procès-verbal de reconstitution comme demande le procureur, mais les deux procès-verbaux de reconstitution, c'est-à-dire Chungek et
S21.
De la même manière, nous demandons à ce que figure dans votre dossier le film de cette reconstitution dont la défense a présenté encore ce matin des
extraits.
En ce qui concerne l'annexe B, comprenant 69 déclarations de témoins recueillies pendant l'instruction, la défense n'a pas d'objection. Par contre, en ce qui concerne l'annexe D,
il vous est
fait mention de 60 documents de S21 qui seraient, et je parle au conditionnel, annotés par l'accusé avec leur traduction respective. Je prie respectueusement la Cour de noter que la défense s'oppose fermement à ce que soit versé au débat des documents de S21 qui n'auront pas été débattus pendant l'audience. Pourquoi? Parce que pendant l'instruction, mais aussi pendant les débats devant cette chambre, vous vous souviendrez que l'on s'est rendu compte ensemble de beaucoup d'erreurs de traduction de ces documents de S21
ហើយយើងឃើញថាមានកំហុសបកប្រែជាច្រើនតាក់ទងទៅនឹងឯកសារទាំងឡាយដែលមកបានមកពីស21ហើយជាការពិតខ្ញុំចងចាំថានៅក្នុងដំណាក់កាលស៊ើបអង្កេតវិញ
ce moment où le bureau des coprocureurs
យើងឃើញមានពេលមួយនោះដែលការិយាល័យសហ
ត្រេសយូទីលីសេ ce matin par le bureau des coprocureurs
ក្នុងការ
ប្រើ Les coprocureurs étaient fiers d'opposer à Douc un document venant de S21 sur lequel soi-disant figurait sa signature et à la vérification le signe que l'on voyait apparaître était seulement un signe de fin de paragraphe qui apparaissait à plusieurs reprises dans le document.Je ne crois qu'à une seule chose, c'est au contradictoire. Personne ne pourra nier que Douc a aidé la conjugation et la chambre a décrypté les documents retrouvés à S21 qui ont été présentés.
ចំពោះការសម្ដែងលើឯកសារទាំងឡាយដែលបានបង្ហាញ
ខ្លួនដូច្នេះ
ហើយ
ទើបយើងសូមអរគុណទៅកាន់ analyser les documents ហើយនឹងការសហការរបស់គាត់
ដែលយើងអាចធ្វើការវិភាគទៅលើឯកសារទាំងឡាយដែលបានជូនគាត់ដូច្នេះហើយ
c'est cet examen contradictoire que l'on a pu déceler de graves erreurs យើងក៏សូមថ្លែងអរគុណ
ចំពោះការពិនិត្យ
dans les interprétations
same thing ដែលយើង
Donc, je dis à mes collègues du bureau des
coprocureurs,
vous avez eu une année d'instruction à votre disposition. Vous avez eu presque une année de procès à votre disposition. Vous avez choisi de nous faire entendre parfois des témoins qui n'avaient aucun intérêt. C'est votre choix. Au lieu de cela,Il vous appartenait de mettre dans la discussion contradictoire ces documents. Vous ne l'avez pas fait. Vous ne pouvez pas aujourd'hui venir demander qu'il soit versé au débat sans avoir été discuté contradictoirement. Enfin, en ce qui concerne le livre de Nick Dunlop,Je rappelle que Douc a un certain nombre de réserves quant à ce livre, quant à certains passages en tout cas de ce livre. Mais cela étant, nous en remettons sur ce point à la sagesse de la Chambre. Voilà pour les observations de la défense. Il y a le même, vous demandera tout à l'heure, l'introduction de sa part de quelques nouveaux documents et non pas de centaines de nouveaux documents. Nous regrettons une fois de plus que le bureau des coprocureurs a utilisé dans un procès où l'accusé reconnaît tout ce qui lui est demandé, croit utile de nous ensevelirsur des dizaines, voire des centaines de pièces qui nécessitent chaque fois des traductions dans les trois langues, qui nécessitent du temps et de l'argent pour ce tribunal.
ហេតុផលនិងសារៈសំខាន់ក្នុងការបង្ហាញទៅលើឯកសារទាំងឡាយដែលគាត់ចង់ដាក់ដែរឯកសារទាំងអស់នោះវាចំណាយធនធានច្រើននៅក្នុងការបកប្រែសូមអរគុណ
ជើញតំណាងថាវិញ្ញាអន្តរជាតិ
Thank you very much, my learned national and international defense colleagues, on your observations. Beginning at the very beginning, Let me respond to my learned friend Met Sawut's observations regarding armed conflict. That certain accused in case file 2 should be burdened with this documentation and not this, because Pol Pot and others higher up in the hierarchy were responsible for this and not this accused. Your Honor, there's some wisdom in that submission. But the problem for the co-prosecutors in their objective and onus to prove the case beyond reasonable doubt is the charge that the learned investigating judges gave to us under the Geneva Conventions. Now, this accused stands charged for various crimes that have been described in the indictment as confirmed by 5 judges of the pre-trial chamber for being charged with grave breaches of the Geneva Conventions. Now, my learned friend very well knows that to prove grave breaches of Geneva Conventions, one has to prove, as the co-prosecutor has to, the existence of an international armed conflict and the connection that's required between the arm, between the crimes of this accused with that armed conflict. Without such a connection and without the proof of an international armed conflict, the charge of Geneva Conventions shall fail. Now, I don't want to go into the history of this case that's come before you in the form of the indictment. Before the investigating magistrates, and even before you in this trial, we submitted that this accused should also be charged with national crimes under the 1956 Penal Code of Cambodia. My learned friends vehemently opposed that. If this accused was charged with national crimes, which he indeed stands charged, only national crimes, this connection with armed conflict would not have been required at all. Now, my learned friend cannot oppose national crimes which don't require armed conflict, and then say that we should not be able to prove armed conflict, which is required for the charges currently labeled against this accused. So we are bound by the requirements of international law to prove an international armed conflict. Your Honor, I'll not burden you with too much of legal or jurisprudential arguments, but I'll just read you a most seminal description of an international armed conflict, but by one of the best judgments written under international law, at least in its earlier years. This was written by the Appeals Chamber of the International Criminal Tribunal for the former Yugoslavia in the famous Tadic decision. The Appeals Chamber, comprising of 5 learned judges, held
Excusez-moi, mon confrère, de vous interrompre, mais je ne pense pas que ce soit le moment de faire votre réquisitoire et de justifier votre demande pour les crimes de guerre. Nous discutons seulement de documents et vous voulez nous faire un cours sur ce que sont les crimes de guerre. Je ne pense pas que ce soit le moment, pardonnez-moi. Si nous voulons terminer ce soir, je ne crois pas que ce soit ça que nous devons faire.
Je ne crois pas que ce soit ça que nous devons faire.
Your Honours, I am not in the business of teaching great doctors of international law like my learned friend is. I was essentially bringing to your attention the requirements of a number of documents to prove armed conflict. And that's why I was reading to you the definition of armed conflict, which I shall not read in deference to my learned friend's suggestion. I should only state that the Tadic decision stated that it has to be a protracted violence between states. Now, clearly, to prove a protracted violence between states over a period of 3 years, 8 months, and 20 days, as we are faced in this court, we would be required to bring such evidence that establishes a continuum of conflict, skirmishes of various types, such that it forms a complete armed conflict throughout the temporal jurisdiction of this court. Therefore, these articles are not repetitive, but they are necessarily required to prove this existence of armed conflict and its protracted nature between states such as Cambodia and Vietnam. So therefore, my respectful submission is that it is not repetitive. It is indeed required. Your Honours wouldn't be willing, like any other judges of any international tribunal, to conclude the existence of armed conflict on the basis of one document, or much less admission of an accused. It will not be countenanced by any judge that an admission of one accused would lead to an unquestionable acceptance of the existence of armed conflict throughout that temporal jurisdiction of this court, and I shall not go further. Regarding a summary, Your Honours, our document of 29th of April 2009 was indeed a one full-page summary of what was contained in these binders. They may look big, but they are indeed a collection of documents that are completely and in detail described in our filing E61 of the 29th of April 2009. However, should my learned friend wish, and the Office of the Co-Prosecutor on its own will provide another summary to my learned friend so as to satisfy his suggestion, and we can discuss that with his office. Your Honours, it was not our desire to omit one report of reenactment, and the co-prosecutors respectfully state before you that Your Honours should also admit the second reenactment, and indeed all such documents associated with the reenactments and reconstructions that were undertaken by the learned co-investigating judges. Regarding Nick Dunlop's book, Your Honours, we are not submitting that Your Honours should rely your judgment on the book of Nick Dunlop. We are bringing it before you, putting it before you for consideration. It may or may not be true, depending on what Your Honours conclude on the basis of other corroborating evidence and the testimony of this accused. And therefore, Your Honours should treat that with the scrutiny, with the strict scrutiny that Your Honours will have to apply to all the documents that are before you in this trial to reach a conclusion. Your Honours, the last point, and which became a bit contentious in the response of my learned friend, is in respect of annotations of this accused on the documents produced at S21. Well, the easier thing for the office of the co-prosecutors would be to go back to its list and filter out such documents, and there were quite a few of them that have been put to this accused or other witnesses during either the judicial investigation or this trial. Once again, in submitting that Your Honours consider these documents, we were not submitting that all of them may or may not have been authentic, or at least authentic in the eyes of this accused. I would respectfully submit, in respect of Annex D, that I would go back to my chambers, make another list, and confer with my learned friend, and come out with a mutually acceptable list in respect of Annex D. And this should be done in reciprocation for the generosity that my learned friend has just demonstrated in respect of acceptance of other documents. We still maintain, though, that these documents are very crucial, contemporaneous, directly relevant, best evidence that this court has before it. After all, trials of this nature, like you are trying, just like Nuremberg, turn on evidence, because no one witness, no one accused can give you a complete picture of what happened at S21 and the nature and extent of the role of this accused during those 3 years, 8 months, and 20 days. The honors will clearly have to rely, equally if not more, on documentary evidence. But in respect of this Annex D, Your Honours may grant us a week or less than that to go back, confer with my learned friend, and come back with a solution, not before the court, but to file it before you, and then Your Honours in writing may choose to decide in the way Your Honours wish to. I hope I have answered all my learned friend's observations. Should Your Honours have further questions, I shall be willing to respond.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Je souhaiterais éventuellement poser quelques questions aux partis pour essayer de clarifier le débat. Nous avons donc quatre séries de documents. S'agissant de la carte qui constitue la première série, je pense qu'il y a, si j'ai compris, un accord absolu entre les parties pour que cette carte soit versée au débat. Nous avons ensuite une deuxième série de documents qui concerne, suivant ce qui a été présenté par les co-procureurs, l'existence d'un conflit armé international. Ce que j'en ai entendu de la part de la défense, c'est qu'il y a une objection tout d'abord de principe en disant que ces documents ne sont pas nécessairement pertinents pour le dossier numéro 1 parce qu'ils concerneraient plutôt le cas des dirigeants du camp Kampuchea démocratique et par ailleurs, il n'y a pas eu d'établissement d'un tribunal international pour juger éventuellement des prisonniers de guerre cambodgiens qui auraient été pris au Vietnam, si j'ai bien compris. Donc c'est sur la pertinence, tout d'abord, qu'il y a une objection. Étant précisé, si j'ai bien entendu également, que la défense en remet également à la sagesse de la Chambre. J'ai entendu également donc, des objections tenant au fait qu'il y a une demande qui concernerait environ 200 articles de presse et, si j'ai bien compris, ce qui est soulevé, c'est le fait que ces articles de presse ne seraient pas suffisamment résumés, en tous les cas, pas suffisamment identifier ou résumer, puisque maintenant nous avons deux possibilités pour verser le document devant la Chambre, soit un résumé, soit une identification. Donc ce que la Défense nous dit, c'est simplement qu'ils ne sont pas suffisamment clairement résumés. Je termine la liste et puis je vous donnerai la parole. Et par ailleurs, si j'ai bien entendu, il y a une opposition également à ce que soient versés en plus de ces articles des documents qui seraient des livres, des rapports militaires ou des vidéos
clips. Voilà.
À ce stade, je n'ai pas entendu d'objection quant au fait que ces documents ne seraient disponibles que dans une seule langue de travail de la Cour. Je souhaiterais que ce point soit bien confirmé et qu'il n'y ait pas de difficulté par la suite. S'agissant par ailleurs donc des procès-verbaux d'interrogatoire ou des procès-verbaux de reconstitution, je pense avoir compris qu'il y avait en fait un accord des parties, en tous les cas des coprocureurs et de la Défense, pour que l'ensemble de ces documents soit effectivement considéré comme étant versé au débat. Il en est de même donc, des déclarations de témoins recueillies pendant au cours d'instruction. S'agissant de l'annexe D, à savoir 60 documents qui présenteraient des annotations de la main de l'accusé, il me semble qu'un certain nombre de ces documents ont déjà été produits au débat. Donc, je ne sais pas si les coprocureurs ont établi une liste de ces documents qui ont déjà été produits au débat, ou s'il s'agit de 60 documents qui sont entièrement nouveaux, qui n'auraient jamais été produits. Parce que je pense que ça ne se présente pas exactement de la même façon. Enfin, s'agissant du livre de Nick Dunlop, là aussi je souhaiterais que les choses soient bien claires de la part de la Défense, qu'elle nous dise si, puisque ce livre n'est disponible que dans une version anglaise, si le fait que ce livre ne soit disponible que dans une version anglaise soulève de sa part une quelconque objection ou non.
Sorry to interrupt. Just to clarify that it's also available in Khmer. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Alors, merci, Monsieur le juge.
En ce
qui concerne les documents à l'appui du conflit armé, la Défense rappelle bien sa position qui figure dans la reconnaissance des faits. Où l'accusé a reconnu qu'il y avait eu des prisonniers de guerre à partir du 31 décembre 1977.
C'est reconnu.
Malgré ça, les coprocureurs ont estimé nécessaire de porter le débat devant votre chambre en demandant à votre chambre de décider que ce conflit armé a couvert toute la période du Kampuchea démocratique. Depuis le début, la Défense a dit que ça n'était pas l'objet du dossier numéro 1. C'est clair, c'est la position de la Défense depuis le début. Le procureur a alors demandé à la Défense si la défense acceptait la production d'environ 200 articles, en fait il y en a plus, je vois 138 plus 87, je pense que vous pourrez nous faire le calcul rapidement, beaucoup plus que ce que moi je ne peux le faire, mais ça fait plus de 200. Donc plus de 200 articles de presse qui ne sont qu'en anglais.
Et j'ai alors dit à mes collègues du co-procureur,
si vous voulez produire ces articles seulement en anglais, je vous demande, sous votre responsabilité, un résumé en français d'une page sur ce que sont ces articles. Ça ne paraît pas très compliqué. À la place de quoi, j'ai eu des dizaines de pages en anglais qui résument article par article. Et voilà comment on noie un tribunal et des services de traduction. Je continue à penser que ces pièces sont totalement superfétatoires. Je continue à dire que si le procureur veut ensevelir la Chambre avec 200 coupures de presse inutiles, qu'il le fasse. Et je n'en demande pas la traduction en français parce que je ne souhaite pas surcharger la traduction. Je demande une chose depuis 6 mois, une page en français de résumé sous votre responsabilité du contenu de ces articles. Est-ce que je suis bien clair? 6 mois. Sur votre autre question, monsieur le juge, elle concerne plus le bureau des coprocureurs, à savoir s'ils pourraient identifier eux-mêmes les documents de S21 qui ont bien été discutés à cette chambre, puisque c'est en général le procureur qui nous a présenté sur les écrans des documents. Il vous sera aisé, je pense, de faire la liste des documents que vous avez présentés et que nous avons débattu contradictoirement. Et je confirme que sur ces documents-là provenant de S21, présentés à l'audience et débattus contradictoirement, ainsi que ceux présentés chez les juges d'instruction et débattus contradictoirement, sur ces documents-là, nous n'avons pas d'objection. Et enfin, monsieur le juge, concernant le livre de Nick Dunlop, je vais effectivement être magnanime, comme le dit mon confrère, dès lors qu'il n'est effectivement pas en français, mais il est en Khmer. Donc, il est dans au moins 2 langues du tribunal. Là aussi, je pense inutile à ce stade du procès de surcharger le service de traduction, même si j'aurais eu beaucoup de plaisir à le lire en version française. Mais nous acceptons à ce stade qu'il n'y ait qu'une version anglaise dans la mesure où il y a aussi une version khmer et que notre carte a pu, pour sa part, lire. Est-ce que j'ai fait le tour de toutes les questions? Oui, pardon, Monsieur le Président, mais à ce stade, alors que nous parlons de tous les documents qui vont être versés au débat, bien entendu, je pense qu'il faut d'ailleurs rajouter le rapport des experts psychologues et psychiatres, ça me paraît aller de soi. Je pense qu'il faudrait que votre chambre ordonne que tous les documents qui seront considérés comme versés au débat puissent être mis sur le site du tribunal. Nous sommes dans un procès public. Il est absolument indispensable que toute personne qui le souhaite puisse avoir accès à des documents, soit qui ont été débattus publiquement, soit dont nous considérons qu'ils ont été débattus publiquement. Il en va, me semble-t-il, d'un principe fondamental qui est celui de la publicité des débats.
ជើញខាងមេធាវីតំណាងដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋបពវិនីតើមានបំណងក្នុងការដាក់ឯកសារអ្វីដែលទីហើយសូមញែកឲ្យច្បាស់លាស់រវាងឯកសារដែលមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងរួចហើយដោយបង្ហាញឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់នៅអត្តសញ្ញាណនៃឯកសារដើម្បីយើងអនុវត្តទៅតាម នីតិវិធីដែលយើងបានណែនាំអនុវត្តកន្លងមកហើយប្រសិនបើមានឯកសារថ្មីដែលមានការបំណងដាក់នោះគឺញែកឲ្យបានដាច់ស្រឡះពីគ្នារវាងឯកសារដែលមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងរួចហើយនិងឯកសារថ្មីដើម្បីងាយដល់ស្រួលដល់អង្គជំរះពិនិត្យពិចារណាក្នុងរយៈពេលខ្លីដើម្បីសម្រេចលើបញ្ហានោះអញ្ជើញក្រុមមួយមុនណា
ជាបឋមនាងខ្ញុំសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានលោកស្រីចៅក្រមនិងអង្គសហនការទាំងមូលនាងខ្ញុំឈ្មោះទីស្រីណាជាមេធាវីតំណាងឲ្យក្រុមដំណឹងរដ្ឋវិនីក្រុមមួយនិងសហភាតារបស់ខ្ញុំគឺលោកអាឡង់វុនណឺថ្ងៃនេះដូចដែលថ្ងៃនេះគឺជាថ្ងៃដែល បញ្ចប់នៃការដេញដោលនាងខ្ញុំក៏សូមធ្វើសំណើពីរសំណើទាំងពីរហ្នឹងគឺជាសំណើដែលដាក់ឯកសារដើម្បីជូនដល់អង្គជំនុំជម្រះនៅក្នុងការពិនិត្យនិងពិចារណា សំណើទី1របស់ខ្ញុំគឺតកតងទៅនឹងឯកសារដែលមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងស្រាប់ហើយនឹងសំណើទី2គឺជាសំណើសុំដាក់នៅឯកសារជាភស្តុតាងថ្មីដែលពុំមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងនោះទេ ឥឡូវនេះនាងខ្ញុំសូមធ្វើលើកជាសំណើទី1ដែលតកតងទៅនឹងឯកសារដែលមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងស្រាប់តកតងនាងខ្ញុំសូមដាក់នៅឯកសារមួយចំនួនដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងចម្លើយសារភាពរបស់ម៉ែនសានហៅយ៉ាដែលមានលេខ EON ពីទំព័រលេខ00097រហូតដល់0006682នៅរវាងទំព័រទាំងនេះគឺនាងខ្ញុំសូមលើកនៅទំព័រមួយចំនួននៅក្នុង EON ទាំងនេះដែល មានទំព័រ EON 00009499 និង EON ដែលមានលេខ 00009500 ត្រង់ចំណារបស់ជនជាប់ចោត នឹង EON ដែលមានលេខ son 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 kau pram chet sub buon trong sum bot dai chun chom chout sa se te kan man san hao ya trong chum noj clear chong krai nei sum bot chum po eon sub tom po chong krai muoi tiet ku dai mien lai eon son 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 9587 trong chumnoj dai chun chop chaot to se teu kan samamut pon trong chumnoj ti 3 nei sambot chumpu ion che phesa angle nang phesa barang nieng khnyom pom ai rok khoeng te nieng khnyom som aphai tos chum pantae ឯកសារទាំងនេះពិតជាមានការបកប្រែរួចជាស្រេចនិងដាក់បញ្ចូលនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងរួចហើយអ្នកខ្ញុំសំណុំពរសូមឲ្យអង្គជំនុំជម្រះមេត្តាពិនិត្យទៅលើទំព័រទាំងនេះដោយលំអិតដើម្បីធ្វើការទុកជាមូលដ្ឋាននៅក្នុងការសម្រេចសក្តីចំពោះសំណើទី2របស់នាងខ្ញុំតកតងទៅនឹងឯកសារថ្មីដែលពុំមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងនៅឡើយនាងខ្ញុំសំណុំពរសូមលើកដាក់ជាសំណើដោយផ្ទាល់មាត់នៅឯកសារជាផុសតាំងថ្មីដែលតកតងទៅនឹងមន្ទីរស21នេះដោយមូលហេតុថាក្រុមនាងខ្ញុំបានធ្វើលិខិតជាលាយលាក់អក្សររួចហើយហើយក្រុមយើងខ្ញុំក៏បានបញ្ជូនទៅខាងការិយាល័យបកប្រែដើម្បីធ្វើការបកប្រែនិងដាក់បញ្ចូលនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងក៏ប៉ុន្តែជាអក្សរដោយសារតែខាងការិយាល័យបកប្រែនោះមកមានញឹកនឹងការបកប្រែឯកសារផ្សេងៗទៀតជាច្រើនពុំអាចធ្វើការបកស្រាយជូនក្រុមយើងខ្ញុំតាន់ពេលវេលាដូច្នេះនាងខ្ញុំស្នើសុំដាក់លិខិតជាលាយលាក់អក្សរតាមក្រោយមុននឹងបញ្ចប់ការសួរសន្និដ្ឋានការពារចំពោះឯកសារដែលជាផុសតាំងតែម្ដងដែលនាងខ្ញុំមានបំណងចង់ដាក់នោះនាងខ្ញុំបានប្រកល់ជូនទៅខាងមេធាវីការពារក្តីដើម្បីធ្វើការពិនិត្យនិងពិចារណាការពិព្រឹកមិញនេះរួចហើយតកតងទៅនឹងឯកសារទាំងនោះគឺនាងខ្ញុំប៉ុនមានកោបំណងដាក់ឯកសារចំនួន18សន្លឹកដែលសុទ្ធតែជាបញ្ជីក្តាប់កម្លាំងអ្នកទោសប្រចាំថ្ងៃនៅមន្ទីរស21នៅក្នុងឯកសារទាំងនោះនឹងគឺមានចំណារបស់ហដែលអូសំតោះគឺមានហត្ថលេខារបស់ហដែលជាបុគ្គលិករបស់មន្ទីរស21ដែលចំណាហត្ថលេខានេះគឺឆ្លុះបង្ហាញថាបញ្ជីនឹងគឺធ្វើឡើងដោយហដើម្បីធ្វើរបាយការណ៍ដាក់បញ្ចូលទៅបញ្ជូនទៅថ្នាក់លើក្នុងការពិនិត្យស្ថានភាពប្រចាំថ្ងៃរបស់មន្ទីរស21នៅក្នុងបញ្ជីទាំងនោះគឺមានតារាងដែលគេធ្វើឡើងដោយដាក់ចំនួនអ្នកទោសប្រចាំថ្ងៃនិងអ្នកទោសដែលត្រូវទៅដឹងបញ្ចូលមកថ្មី ក៏ដូចជាអ្នកទោសដែលបានស្លាប់នៅក្នុងមន្ទីរស-21ក៏ដូចជាអ្នកទោសត្រូវយកកំទៅកំទេច ក្រុមនាងខ្ញុំគិតថាបញ្ជីនេះគឺជាភស្តុតាងថ្មីមួយដែលសំខាន់ដែលគួរគប្បីបញ្ចូលទៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងស-01នេះគឺដោយសារតែបញ្ជីនេះបង្ហាញអំពីស្ថានភាពរបស់អ្នកទោសនៅមន្ទីរស-21ដែលនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងពុំមានឯកសារជាលេខអក្សរណាមួយបង្ហាញអំពីស្ថានភាពជាក់ស្ដែងនៅក្នុងមន្ទីរស-21នោះឡើយចំណុចមួយទៀតបញ្ជីនេះក៏ឆ្លុះបង្ហាញយ៉ាងច្បាស់ផងដែរគឺតកតងទៅនឹងអ្នកទោសនៅមន្ទីរស-21ដែលបានស្លាប់ ដោយមជ្ឈបាយផ្សេងៗដែលផ្ទុយពីការសំយកទៅកំទេចនៅជើងឯកនៅក្នុងការកំទេចនោះគឺនៅក្នុងបញ្ជីទាំងនោះក៏បានបង្ហាញដែរគឺការកំទេចដោយការយកឈាមនិងអ្នកទោសនៅមន្ទីរស-21នឹងបានចងកសម្លាប់ខ្លួនឯង គឺមានន័យថាសម្លាប់ខ្លួនឯងនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់នៃមន្ទីរស-21 ហើយបញ្ជីនេះក៏បានបង្ហាញទៀតផងដែរថាមានអំពើទារុណកម្មដោយអ្នកទោសនៅក្នុងនោះគាត់បានស្លាប់ដោយអំពើទារុណកម្មស្លាប់ដោយជំងឺរាករូសផ្សេងៗទៀត នឹងស្លាប់ដោយទារុណកម្មនៅក្នុងកំឡុងពេលសួរចម្លើយនៅក្នុងមន្ទីរស-21 នៅក្នុងនោះដែរក្រុមនាងខ្ញុំក៏បានធ្វើការពិនិត្យនិងពិច័យនិងធ្វើការប្រៀបធៀបបញ្ជីនេះជាមួយនឹងបញ្ជីដែលមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងស្រាប់ដែលមានលេខ E68.1 ដែលជាបញ្ជីកំទេចអ្នកទោសដែលបានកែប្រែរួចហើយដែលអង្គសម្ណាការនេះលើកយកមកពិភាក្សាដេញដោលដើម្បីឆ្លុះបង្ហាញថា អ្នកទោសនឹងឈ្មោះនិងអត្តសញ្ញាណរបស់អ្នកទោសដែលបានស្លាប់នៅក្នុងមន្ទីរស-21 យើងបានធ្វើការប្រៀបធៀបតើយើងឃើញថាឈ្មោះអ្នកទោសដែលមាននៅក្នុងបញ្ជីក្តាប់កម្លាំងអ្នកទោសប្រចាំថ្ងៃនេះភាគច្រើនគឺពុំមាននៅក្នុងបញ្ជី កំទេចរបស់មន្ទីរស-21នោះទេនេះគឺជាហេតុមួយដែលបង្ហាញពីភាពខុសគ្នាហើយក៏ជាឯកសារថ្មីក៏ជាភស្តុតាងថ្មីតែមួយគត់ដែលយើងអាចយកមកបំភ្លឺនិងដើម្បីយកមកបំភ្លឺនៅក្នុងសារសំណាការនេះដូច្នេះហើយនាងខ្ញុំគិតថា បញ្ជីដែលនាងខ្ញុំរកឃើញថ្មីទាំងចំនួន 18 នេះគួរគប្បីបញ្ចូលទៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងព្រោះវាជាប្រយោជន៍ដល់អង្គសំណាការនៅក្នុងការបង្ហាញទៅការពិតនិងដើម្បីរកជួយនិងដើម្បីជួយរកយុត្តិធម៌ដល់អ្នកទោសដែលបានស្លាប់នៅក្នុងមន្ទីរស-21 ដូច្នេះនាងខ្ញុំសំណូមពរសូមឲ្យលោកប្រធានមេត្តាទទួលយកនៅបញ្ជីទាំងនេះធ្វើជាភស្តុតាងនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿង 001 នេះចាប់ពីពេលនេះតទៅសូមអរគុណ
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs les juges. Très brièvement, pour complémenter ce que ma collègue a indiqué, peut-être qu'il y avait juste peut-être le langage sur juste, j'aimerais juste être sûr que les choses soient claires sur deux points rapidement. D'abord, pour être correct avec le service d'interprétation. Comme vous le savez peut-être, les parties civiles ont été assez occupés ces derniers jours parce que selon votre ordre, nous devons déposer demain une motion sur la réparation. Et donc il y a eu beaucoup de discussions parmi les parties civiles et il nous a été possible de déposer qu'aujourd'hui pour traduction la motion dont vous a parlé ma collègue Tishina. C'est la raison pour laquelle nous avons donné cette motion à nos confrères du, de la défense aussi tôt que possible, c'est-à-dire il y a juste deux heures, et nous attendons à ce que cette motion soit traduite pas avant la semaine prochaine, étant donné que vendredi et lundi prochain sont des jours fériés. C'est la raison pour laquelle nous nous sommes permis de, en plus, faire une soumission orale, ce qui permettra à mes confrères de la défense de répondre et d'avoir un maximum d'éléments devant votre chambre. Juste un élément supplémentaire sur l'unicité de cette demande et sa relevance, le fait que c'est important pour nos parties civiles. Et la raison est celle-ci. Comme vous l'a dit Tishrina, ce que nous avons découvert, d'abord c'est 18 listes d'une page, parce que c'est des listes journalières. Donc c'est 18 pages, 18 listes d'une page. Et il en existait probablement, s'il y a réellement une liste par jour, ce qui semble être le cas, il y aurait beaucoup d'autres listes. Donc, nous parlons de 18 listes maintenant. Ce qui nous semble important, c'est que, effectivement, dans ces listes, nous avons 18 noms. 18 noms de personnes qui ont été détenues à S21. Et dans notre motion, nous déposerons également une attestation de tout le slang, nous disant que ces listes ont été effectivement trouvées à S21. Ces 18 noms sont des personnes, comme vous l'a dit Tishrina, qui n'ont pas été exécutées, mais qui sont mortes par divers moyens, soit par la torture, soit à cause des conditions de détention, dans un cas, un suicide. Sur ces 18 noms, on a comparé ces 18 noms, comme vous l'a dit Tishrina, avec la liste consolidée des coprocureurs, et dans 14 des 18 cas, ces noms n'existent pas. En d'autres termes, ces listes journalières font mention de personnes qui sont décédés autrement qu'ayant été exécutés et donc leur nom ne figure pas dans la liste consolidée. C'est important pour nous, pourquoi? Parce que, comme vous le savez, quatre de nos clients, et je me suis longuement exprimé à ce sujet, nous n'avons pas été en mesure d'apporter des preuves supplémentaires, et comme l'accusé et ses avocats l'ont justement relevé, dans ces quatre cas, il n'y a pas de nom, les noms des proches de nos clients ne figurent pas sur la liste consolidée. Donc d'avoir ces listes au dossier et devant votre chambre permettra à notre avis de soutenir notre argument qu'il est absolument probable, comme je l'ai déjà plaidé, que les gens soient décédés à S21, peut-être par d'autres moyens, pas en ayant été exécutés, mais par maladie, par torture ou par suicide ou par d'autres moyens. Et ces personnes, ce serait donc logique que ces personnes, leur nom ne se trouve pas sur la liste consolidée. Et encore une fois, nous pensons que c'est important que nous puissions nous baser sur ces documents parce que ça nous aidera à soutenir notre argumentaire final que pour nos quatre clients, le fait que leur nom ne figure pas sur la liste consolidée ne veut pas dire que ces personnes n'aient pas été détenues à S21. Juste encore un mot complémentaire et j'en aurai fini pour vous dire que nous avons été constitués dans ce dossier en janvier. Que, comme vous le savez, nous avons des moyens limités, une équipe limitée. Nous avons fait vraiment notre mieux pour faire le tour des documents. Il a fallu beaucoup de temps pour faire le tour des documents. Et nous avons fait preuve de toute la diligence possible pour comprendre tous les documents dans ce dossier. Et ma collègue a passé énormément de temps à tout slang, façon manuelle, comme nous vous l'expliquons dans nos écritures, pour identifier ces documents. Et nous, réellement, pensons de bonne foi. Nous savons que c'est tard, mais réellement, nous pensons de bonne foi que c'est important, non seulement pour le cas, mais aussi pour nos clients spécifiquement, que ces documents sont
ខ្ញុំគិតថាបញ្ជីចំនួន18នេះវាមានសារៈសំខាន់ណាស់សម្រាប់កូនក្រីរបស់យើងហើយស្គាល់សម្រាប់រឿងក្រីរបស់យើងផងដែរដូច្នេះហើយគឺខ្ញុំស្នើសុំឲ្យដាក់បញ្ជីទាំង15នេះសូមអរគុណមេធាវីតំណាងដើមរងរួយក្រុមមួយអាចបញ្ជាក់បានទីមួយប្រភពនៃឯកសារដែលទទួលបានហើយទី2ហេតុផលមិនទៅបានជាឯកសារទាំងនេះមានការយឺតយ៉ាវរហូតដល់ពេលនេះហើយទើបតែស្នើសុំដាក់
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាននាងខ្ញុំនឹងធ្វើការបំភ្លឺតាក់ទងទៅនឹងឯកសារនេះគឺយើងរកបាននៅសារៈមន្ទីរទួលស្លែងដោយនាងខ្ញុំបានខំប្រឹងចំណាយពេលវេលាយ៉ាងយូរដើម្បីធ្វើការស្វែងរកឯកសារដោយសហភេតាបស់ខ្ញុំបានលើកឡើងបញ្ញមិញទើបយើងរកបាននៅឯកសារទាំងនេះហើយនៅក្នុងនោះដែរយើងក៏បានធ្វើការស្នើសុំថតចម្លងដោយការស្នើសុំថតចម្លងនោះយើងត្រូវការចំណាយពេលវេលាយូរ គឺយើងមានការស្នើសុំទៅខាងក្រសួងវប្បធម៌និងវិចិត្រសិល្បៈដែលជាក្រសួងគ្រប់គ្រងទៅលើហើយសារមន្ទីរឧក្រិដ្ឋកម្មបលាយពូចសាសនេះអញ្ចឹងយើងមានការស្នើសុំទៅគាត់សិនដើម្បីសុំលិខិតអនុញ្ញាតនៅក្នុងការថតចម្លងឯកសារនៅសារមន្ទីរទួលស្លែងដល់ពេលយើងតម្រុំនឹងយើងទៅទទួលបាននៅលិខិតនេះគឺយើងចំណាយពេល 3 ថ្ងៃទៅមកទឹកពីព្រោះថាភ្នាក់ងារនៅទីនោះជួនកាលគាត់ចប់រវល់ពុំអាចធ្វើលិខិតនឹងបានអញ្ចឹងមានការយឺតយ៉ាវតម្រុំយើងទទួលបានលិខិតនឹងគឺរហូតដល់ថ្ងៃទី26 ខែសីហាឆ្នាំ2009នេះទើបបានយើងទទួលបានលិខិតនោះនៅពេលដែលយើងទទួលបានហើយយើងត្រូវការចំណាយពេលវេលាដើម្បីនៅក្នុងពិនិត្យទៅលើដើមអំណងរបស់ពលរដ្ឋនេះយើងខ្ញុំដូចសហភាពតាខ្ញុំបានលើកឡើងម្ញមិញអញ្ចឹងយើងត្រូវការចំណាយពេលវេលានឹង ដើម្បីពិនិត្យទៀតហើយចំណុចមួយទៀតពាក់ព័ន្ធជាមួយនឹងមូលហេតុនៃការយឺតយ៉ាវនៅក្នុងការដាក់ឯកសារនេះនាងខ្ញុំសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គសំណាកាថាក្រុមនាងខ្ញុំដែលបានកកើតឡើងដើម្បីចូលរួមនៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿង 001 នេះគឺយើងចាប់ផ្ដើមនៅពាក់កណ្ដាលខែ1នៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ 2000 នេះគឺជាពេលវេលាមួយនៃការបတ်ការស៊ើបសួររួចហើយ ហើយក៏ជាពេលវេលានៃការចាប់ផ្ដើមនីតិវិធីសន្និការដូច្នេះហើយយើងឃើញថាពេលវេលានេះគឺជាពេលវេលាមួយដែលមានការផាត់ផោយសម្រាប់យើងនៅក្នុងការសិក្សាទៅលើឯកសារជាច្រើនដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធជាមួយនឹង សំណុំរឿង 001 នេះហើយទន្ទឹមនឹងនោះដែរទោះបីជាវាជាក្រុមយើង មានរយៈពេលខ្លីនៅក្នុងការសិក្សាសំណុំរឿងនេះក៏ពួកយើងនៅតែខំប្រឹងប្រែងស្វះស្វែងដើម្បីរកភស្តុតាងនិងឯកសារជាច្រើនដើម្បីមកបំភ្លឺនៅក្នុងសារសំណាកានេះដើម្បីស្វែងរកការពិតនៅក្នុងនោះដែរយើងក៏បានព្យាយាមស្វែងរកភស្តុតាងជារៀងរាល់ថ្ងៃទោះបីជាយើងមានការរវល់នៅក្នុងការចូលរួមសំណាកាក៏ដោយនៅពេលទំនេរយើងឆ្លៀតពេលដើម្បីស្វែងរកភស្តុតាងបន្ថែមយើងបានសិក្សាទៅលើសំណុំរឿង
នឹងរកឯកសារផ្សេងៗដើម្បីមកបង្ហាញនតិបំភ្លឺនៅអង្គសារសំណាកានេះនេះគឺជាមូលហេតុនៃការដាក់ឯកសារយឺតយ៉ាវសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានឥឡូវនេះដល់ម៉ោង 18:30 ហើយអង្គរិះប្រកាសសម្រាប់ 18:30 សូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការ
សំណាកការបស់យើង
សូមអញ្ជើញក្រោយចូល